Firefighters filled Milwaukee City Hall tonight, fuming over cuts to their department. New at 10, 12 News' Brendan Conway is live at City Hall. And Brendan, this is the latest move by firefighters to try to stop these cuts.
Yeah, Kathy, firefighters are really using everything they have to try and stop the cuts, including tonight invoking the actions of two local firefighters who became national heroes. When an SUV rolled over and burst into flames on Layton Avenue in July, off-duty firefighters John and Joel Reichlitz rushed in, and despite receiving burns themselves, helped save the life of a little boy trapped inside. During a budget hearing at City Hall, firefighters highlighted those heroic actions as a reason cuts to their department are so dangerous.
Cut one of those people from that incident. Do we get the same result? I don't know.
Dozens of people expressed their concerns to Mayor Barrett and the Common Council about budget cuts to the Art Board and Sanitation Department. But in the end, public safety was the big issue. Wearing red shirts that say no more cuts, firefighters entered en masse, with one after another saying proposed cuts from 5 to 4 person ladder crews is a hazard.
We accept the fact that we may die in the line of duty, but please don't accelerate that for us.
When you're cutting frontline firefighters, frontline police officers, you're risking people's lives.
Police officers are facing 4 unpaid furlough days next year, but they were noticeably absent from the hearing. Only one person, an off-duty detective, spoke on their behalf. He says Milwaukee is one of only a few large cities with plans to furlough cops.
When 61 of the largest cities can pay their police officers, Milwaukee can't. There's obviously a systemic problem here with what's going on with the way the money's being spent.
Mayor Barrett and Fire Chief Doug Holton have repeatedly said that these proposed cuts will not affect public safety. The ball is now in the hands of the Common Council. They, at the end of the month, will have the opportunity to make some proposed changes to the budget. Then the full council will vote on it early next month. Reporting live outside City Hall, Brendan Conway, WISN 12 News.
Thanks.